beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands on golden sands and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere beyond the sea. She's there watching for me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her arms I'll go sailing.
During our time in Biarritz, we visited a traveling exhibition about the deep abyss. Although we had learned about the abyss in class, I was utterly mesmerized by the images that I saw. Now, if I was to describe and characterize the deep sea, I would say, 1, it's dark, 2, it's cold, 3, it's deep, and 4, it's hungry.
And what really shocked me about this underwater world was that the deep sea forests were built of animals instead of trees. Whilst we were there, we witnessed some amazing bioluminescent creatures, and we learned all about their physical characteristics and about how they adapt to their harsh environment.
The females are the boss among the anglerfish, and they can choose 2 or 3 males to carry around and do with as they please. This should be the case in our world as well.
We ventured out with Teddy, a champion lifesaver who taught us how to save victims that get caught in the ocean. Before we started anything, he quoted a piece of writing from Michael Morpego about the ocean. You have to remember always that she's your leader, not you. You are dancing to her tune. Once we understood this, we were more comfortable with the water. Although the lifesaving drills we undertook taught us about survival and safety, we also learned about teamwork, trust, and shared adventure. My favorite part was at the very end, when we were jumped off the 3-meter diving board. Each jump gave me such a great rush.
We'll all be planning out a route we're gonna take real soon. We're waxing down our surfboard. We can't wait for June. We'll all be gone for the summer. We're on safari to stay. Tell the teacher we're surfing USA.
One thing amazed me about the surfers we saw at Biarritz. They were attuned to the water. They stared at it for hours on end. They could read its changes, and they looked for the smallest indication that the next wave will be the perfect one.
What I loved about surfing was that I was in the water as well as on it. I could feel the power of the wave slamming me down to the bottom, scraping the sand, holding my breath for dear life. Then fighting upward against the whirling power to break through. And then jumping back onto my board for next ultimate 15 or 30 or 60 second ride. After having been surfing, I can understand Kelly Slater's famous quote, "For a surfer, it's never ending. There's always some wave you want to surf." My next challenge is to surf super tubes in Peniche.
Yeah, everybody's gonna surf.
How does ocean and nature inspire you?
A lot. That's, for me, that's the most important, because we can't live without the nature, and for me it's a playground. I'm also a surfer and I make spear fishing, so I dive. So the ocean is very important because I practice it on all the levels, on the beach, on the waves, under the water, and here we've got also the mountains, and so it's something we have to protect and very take care about, and that's why you see I pick up some rubbish on the beach, and I invite you to do the same. It's something very easy we can do every day. Like when we go on the beach, we always have one free hand to pick up some rubbish and put it on the garbage. Mm-hmm. And so we will find the beach cleaner than we found it when we arrived. So sometimes I also write some sentences on the beach to open the conscience, open the mind of the people about the surrounding and about the nature, and to take care about it.
I woke up from the same dream, falling backwards, till it turned me inside out. Now I live a waking life, looking backwards, a model citizen, a doubt.